We're shooting in the rain. We're shooting in the rain. Hi, welcome to the ITSF World Cup Changwon 2018. This is the trap women's final, the third final we've had today, and the first shotgun event of this competition. And it is a very, very soggy Changwon. The rain is pouring, but that's not going to dampen the spirits of this audience here in South Korea. All these athletes out there competing for those three medals up for grabs. My name's Jamie Stangrim, and I am joined by Finnish trap shooter Mopsy Faroma. Hello, Mopsy.
Hi.
Thank you for joining me. Yeah, again, we met in Guadalajara, didn't we, for the World Cup back in March?
Yes.
We commentated on the mixed team event, didn't we?
Yes.
It went very well for Finland.
Yes, and I think now too.
Well, yes, speaking of which, athletes competing today. Let's meet them. This is Rory McAllister, our announcer here in Changwon.
She was a gold medalist at the World Cup in Larnaca last year, 2017, and 17 World Cup final in New Delhi last year. Wang Xiaoqing! Hello, at position number 3, representing Spain. She won a silver medal at the World Cup final in New Delhi last year and a bronze medal at the World Cup final in Nicosia 2015. Fatima Gomez! At position at number 4, representing Finland. She's been Olympic gold at Beijing Olympic Games and has 5 World Cup gold medals. Sasu Nakamura!
And I'm sure Mopsy will tell us more about Satu a little bit later on.
Number 5, representing Australia. The gold medalist at the World Cup in New Delhi last year. Kevin Smith! And finally, at position number 6, representing the Russian Federation. She won 2 World Cup silver medals and a bronze medal at the World Cup. Natalia Bastu!
There are our athletes in this trap women's final. Thank you to Rory, our announcer in the rain, for introducing them to us. So, Mopsy, it would be a stupid question for me to ask you who you're betting on in this final.
Finland, like last time.
You're so biased, aren't you? You are so biased. So, what can you tell us about Satu, your teammate out there?
She shot really strongly this competition, 75 yesterday from 75, and today a little bit less, but still strongly in the final, no problem. And like last time with Vesa, hi to Vesa to Finland from the mixed team with Satu, they rose from the last place, and now she's not even in the last place.
That's true. That's absolutely true. So yeah, hello to Vesa as well. Where is Vesa at the moment?
Home.
Home.
Yeah.
Okay.
But in the spirit with us.
Watching online, watching our stream at the moment.
Yes, yeah. I'm sure of it.
Well, if not. It can always be watched back on YouTube. This final will be there at some point in the very near future. So it'll be 25 targets till our first elimination. And then after each five additional targets, we'll be saying goodbye to another athlete until the bronze medal's been decided after 40. And then we'll have another 10 between the last two remaining athletes to decide the gold medal. So that'll be after 50. They're up and running here. Was a miss for Perilli. Hey. Hit for Wang.
Oi.
Galvez. And Satu of Finland, as you probably heard from the Nordics that Mopsy released there with a miss. But early days, let's not get worried. Hit for Penny Smith as well. And we're on to Busuk of Russian Federation now. And we have heard that Petty Smith has a 1-point deduction for a reporting time violation. So thank you to actually our announcer, Rory, who's multitasking right now. He's announcing on his final, but also delivering vital information to me. So thank you, Rory. So confirmation, Penny Smith, 1 point deduction for a reporting time violation. What can you tell us about a reporting time violation, Mopsy?
No, I'm not sure, but maybe we have these times to give the cartridge and for the jury to check them. Maybe she was late from that, or the reporting time that everybody has to be here at 1 point, is it 15 minutes before they start? So maybe she was a little bit missing that.
So essentially it's probably a punctuality issue.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Finnish girls don't know that.
What?
Finnish girls don't know what that means.
Oh,
we are always on time.
Are you always on time, yeah?
Like you know from Guadalajara.
I do remember that, yeah. You were early.
Yeah, half an hour.
On time. You were early, which is not on time. But I guess it's better than late, isn't it?
Yes.
There's no point deductions for turning early to commentate with me anyway.
And I don't want to know what your rejection would be.
I'll just take away the bottle of water I gave you, I suppose. That's all I can, I guess. There's no fee involved for this commentary. You do know that, right?
Maybe you don't take it next time.
Well, let's see. This final's young. Let's see how you perform. Miss for Penny Smith there.
Like it's not that heavily raining, a little bit, but no roof, so it's not that nice, actually.
No, it's persistent, this rain. It's been going all day, isn't it?
Yeah.
Pretty much.
Yeah.
And how, on a scale of 1 to 10, just how challenging are these conditions for the athletes out there now? What would you say, with 10 being as challenging as it gets?
Maybe 4 or 5, because there's no wind, and it's not that heavily raining yet, at least. So I think they will manage. This is like moist rain, not that heavy. So it's going to be good. Like you see, they're shooting good.
They are, yeah. Well, as we said, that is another miss for
Penny.
And Tatiana Barsic has just got her first hit on the table. I believe tomorrow there's more rain forecast, but then after that, it's going to be nice and sunny.
Yeah. The ski shooters get all the sunny days.
Yeah, sunny for the ski.
Yeah. But they don't have the roofs than us, usually.
And will you be involved in the trap?
No. I'm heading home.
You're going home?
Yeah.
So tomorrow?
No, day after tomorrow, but Satu and Vili Kopra is shooting the mix for Finland.
Right.
Yep.
And how are those decisions made? I mean, did you put yourself forward? Did you not want to do it? Or
No. We had competitions where they bosses takes who is the best, and then they mix the teams. We should have had two teams, but Vesa is now home, and then they changed the other team to be Vili and Satu.
Right, okay. So hopefully at another World Cup soon you'll get a go in the...
Maybe Malta, maybe.
Cool. Well, I look forward to seeing that. I'll be in Malta, and obviously if you're not, you're more than welcome to join me
again. Thank you, I will gladly come.
But let's see how this one goes first. It's not over yet. But we've all had 5 targets. Well, I say the athletes out there. And I am doing my best to work with the scoreboard we have.
Calves Fatima going strongest.
5 hits, is that?
Yeah,
you've got much better eyesight than me. So just so the viewers know, we've got one scoreboard that we're working from. There are a few technical issues here, and it's quite a long way away. But luckily, Mopsy has her contact lenses in, so you're steering me through this.
And Mäkelä, Nummela and Wang had 4. They were in the second place. Then I don't know what it's...
Well, Barsac had 2 hits after missing the first 3, finished strongly, and Penny Smith was the opposite, in fact, hit the first 2, missed the last 3 from
but
what I can
see. But having the 1 point away, I think.
Of course, yeah. Has that point been taken into consideration?
I don't think it's there.
No, it doesn't look like it has been. So hopefully that information was correct that I received from Rory, our announcer, earlier. If it is correct, it's not being taken into account on the scoreboard we're working from. So we'll see. Chavez still yet to miss.
In the lead. With seven targets.
Pretty good going, isn't it?
Yeah.
But very, very, very early days still.
Yeah. Still over 15 to go. 17.
As the rain continues to fall. Can't see the rain as much now. I don't know if it's dying down, but it's certainly falling as far as the sound that we're hearing from the roof above us would suggest. But it looks like it might be dying down a little bit out there.
Now they're stopping it. I think, was it Pirelli that
was there a protest?
Yeah, I think.
So Pirelli there's at the scoreboard, it's down as a miss.
Yeah, and there's an umbrella just in front of me, so.
Yeah, we have got a lot of obstructions in our way.
Yeah.
Umbrellas galore, humans as well, pesky humans.
Because I think I saw a dust, but sometimes they break when they go off, so I think they have to see a piece, and now he's going to ask the side referees what did they see and make a decision. And he will tell it to Pirelli. And let's see. No, it's continuing.
Okay.
So I think it was a loss.
So that means Pirelli will remain on four hits?
Yep.
And it's
Wang.
So you talked about Satu at the start. What else do you know about some of the other shooters out there? Are there any that you're particularly familiar with? I mean, there's some big names out there.
Yeah, big names, not that acquaintance. I was more acquaintance with the girls from Slovakia. You got me out.
Yeah, so when
so
I
girls.
Approached you to be my my guest,
yeah, I left
you were chatting with
for you.
The Slovakian team, weren't you?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I left them for you.
You did. You did. Yeah, you win points for that.
Thank you. And, well, Fatima, I have maybe seen most, but not that much. Pirelli, I think, in Baku. I'm always confused with Pirelli. There is two. Was in Europeans last year in the final one, maybe. I'm really like I told you last time.
Let me tell you, in fact, because whilst we don't have computer technology in front of us like we usually would, I do have very futuristic paper technology with biographies on, so we can actually get to the bottom of that mystery. So let's have a look. Pirelli. So we were talking about the European Championships.
Last year? Baku? No.
Where are we? No, I think you just made that up.
Yeah,
what do you mean this year's one? Because maybe it's not been updated this year's
one. I think it was the... is it sister? I'm a little bit confused, like I told you.
It must be the other one. It's the other one.
Yeah. But because I think they both are Pirelli A, and you just see them from behind or on the scoreboard, and... Oh. I'm bad with names and faces.
Well, Alessandro, who's out there now, she's very experienced. Regardless of that medal, whether it's hers or not, there's still seven World Cup medals to her name, two of which are of the gold kind. Three bronzes as well, two of which were from last year, Monaco and Acapulco. Also two silvers, that's pretty decent.
Yeah, they are all good shooters, and they have so many wins and medals, and it's just awesome to see their shoot. It's really nice looking. And
yeah, a lot of experience out there, so I'm sure they've all seen conditions like this before and worse, because like you only give it a four or five out of ten. But we're back with, I'm trying to look above the umbrellas, should be back with Galvez.
Soon we are.
Bounce back after her first miss.
Yeah. And after a few targets, it's 10 for everybody.
That's right. Couple of misses there.
Yeah.
Satu and also Penny.
Maybe if she knows there's this violation, it's maybe a little bit in the mind. Or.
So that's 10 targets. In fact, Galvez, and apologies, like I say, we are working from a scoreboard that's far away. There's two misses, so on a total of
eight. Two.
Joint leader with Wang. And then in third place, outright third place, we have your friend, don't we? Your teammate from Finland. And then we have Barsack, who had a slow start but is in fourth place.
With Perilli.
Six hits alongside, Perilli. And that leaves
Penny Smith to the last place at the moment.
At the moment, but yeah, we still have.
I think she had birthday a few days back.
Really? Well, you know what? I can tell you whether we can confirm this one.
You have the papers.
I do have the papers, so let's have a look. So we're not sure what happened earlier when you talked about Baku and Perilli, but maybe you're talking
maybe
sense
now.
This time. Let's have a look. Penny Smith. Oh, no, it doesn't say her birthday. I mean, we know she's 22 years, 11 months, and 26 days
okay.
of age.
Okay. Quite close.
Yeah, but it hasn't got her birthday on exactly. But. I mean, I don't know how up to date that is, to be honest, the 11 months, 26 days. But anyway, I'll just take your word for it. I trust you, Mopsy. Not sure if I should, but I'm going to go with it.
Yeah, you should think twice. They're really close, everybody, to each other.
Yeah, very close.
So interesting, 15 ahead.
Yep, so 15 until our first elimination. A couple of misses.
Yeah.
With Galvez now, Spain hits that one. And a miss for Satu.
Yep.
It's an important hit for Penny Smith. And another one for Barsack.
I think she's the youngest.
You're making another claim.
But here, I have to try
I
many
can't
times.
Back up. Let's. She's Tatiana Barsack. You mean?
No, Penny.
Oh, Penny. Okay, because Tatiana's 33, and Wang is definitely back. I can see 25. Fatima is 31. Satu is 47. Penny Smith 42. So you were right. We can verify that one. We can verify.
Third is a charm.
Yeah.
More paparazzis.
I know. People want our photos, don't they?
They like us.
They do like. We're obviously a winning team, but they can't hear what we're saying.
Yeah.
If they heard what we were saying. Littered with potential inaccuracies, then I'm not sure they'd want our photo. They'd be deleting those photos.
The miss for Wang.
Yep. It's certainly still close out there.
Yep. Galvez in the lead still. Hey. Good. Only double bomb or one.
And a good hit for. Finland.
Yeah. And Penny.
Yeah, Penny's going well and she needs that.
Yeah, she got it now. So as you see, the rain is not any trouble for them.
No,
they're shooting really
handling
nicely.
It very well.
Because
it's certainly still falling. But it's not bothering the shooters out there. But still, not nice conditions, I'm sure, to be out there shooting in. Not just with guns, but also cameras. We have Stefano and John, our cameramen, out there in the rain, bringing you the pictures. Meanwhile, the rest of our team, because we're out here, we're out in the rain, we are kind of undercover, slightly. The rest of our team are inside a nice, warm, cozy office.
Okay.
They're the ones dealing with the graphics. And also cutting between the various pictures. And they are Fabio and Luigi. And they're dry. Lucky them. So let's take a look at the scores.
Yeah, Galvez in the lead. Mm-hmm. Then Wang and Mäkelän Ummela second. And also Barsuk, Tatiana, was it? And then there's Perilli on fifth place. And Penny Smith sixth.
I'm so glad you've got good eyesight.
I'm glad I have the contact lenses.
It'd be a bit of a problem then, wouldn't we?
Yeah.
Should be making it up. But yes, so Penny Smith is still chasing the pack, but she's only one hit behind her closest rival, which is Perilli, if her eyes are correctly seeing what they're seeing, potentially seeing. We do have to remember as well, if we get to a tiebreak situation when the eliminations come into play, of course, the bib number is all important, isn't it?
Yeah.
So, the higher bib number, pennies, is five, position five anyway.
Yes.
Will come into play if she's up against Pirelli, who goes five first.
And now one for Tatiana, a loss.
But we talked about Penny Smith being the youngest, but she's a lifeguard, by the way, back in Australia.
Wow.
She's a lifeguard, wow. If the rain keeps falling, she might come in handy here. Cause it's very, away from the rain, down at the kind of concourse, it's kind of flooded, isn't it?
A little bit. Lucky we are a little bit higher.
I was going to say before I was distracted by her profession away from shooting, is that despite the age, she's still experienced, isn't she? She appeared in a number of finals, World Championships, World Cup final, gold from New Delhi, 2017. You know that final well, don't you?
Yeah, I do.
How did you do in that one?
I was third.
You were third,
and I was saved by the bib number.
There we go. And that was probably one of the first World Cups that new rule was in use, wasn't it?
Yeah, I think so.
That was in February last year, wasn't it?
Yes.
Yes, in fact, it was probably the first World Cup.
Yeah.
Where the bib, so yeah, good for you. And congratulations again on that bronze.
Thank you.
I announced it.
My first
I
one.
I announced it.
Another one.
I'm not trying to claim any credit, but you did all the work.
Yeah,
yeah. Yeah, and I hope there are more medals in you, Mopsy.
A loss for Penny. They were going all strong now, but
yeah, first miss in a little while. Oh,
you see so
there
much green.
Two.
Yeah, that was for Russia.
Yeah, last second. And a hit for Pirelli. Back with Penny Smith.
And a hit.
Yep, so she bounced back after that blip from before. Can Barsack do the same?
Yes.
She can.
And I think this final and this competition is really important because in September we have the World Championships here, and
that's
the first quarters is up for grabs.
So it's a very important one.
Yeah.
And also, this whilst this is a World Cup in its own right, of course, this is also serving as a test event for the venue, for the World Championships, because a lot of it is brand new, particularly in the rifle pistol finals. So it's all been completely renovated. Is it your first time in Taiwan?
Yeah.
How are you finding it?
I like these ranges. It's really nice looking, and I think it's really nice place, the venue and everything. Big houses and places where to put everything. And now we have Galvez on the first place, and then Wang and Mäkelä Nummela third, and then Barasuk and Pirelli on the fourth place, and Penny back in the sixth place.
Yeah, so Penny Smith is one hit behind the two athletes.
Yeah.
The Mopsy mentioned tied in fourth place. And we are five targets away now, aren't we? From the first elimination.
Yes.
So we ain't going to have a shoot-off, but the bib number, if Penny Smith can pull it back, could be all important. She has got a better bib number than Barsack. But not Pirelli.
And now we don't know about the 1 point from the...
Yeah, that's a good point. I'd forgotten about that, but that's a very good point. Has it been deducted? We'll wait and see.
I hope your friend knows.
Yeah.
We'll be just quiet and he will lead the
way. We can ask him. Yeah, well, he's the announcer, so he's the one.
Yeah.
He's the voice of God, if you like, so we'll go with him. He's the Morgan Freeman of the ISSF.
But Penny taking a loss again.
Yeah, that's not good for her.
Yeah.
Silly, obvious comment to make, but she needs to hit as many as possible.
But three more. Everything can happen.
Yeah, it ain't over yet. And there are a few misses out there.
Yeah, and like now, apparently got a loss. So, okay, somebody
see
else.
Wobbles.
It was Wang.
That was Wang, yeah. Now we're on to Galvin, the leader.
Yeah.
No problem for her. She's on to 19 hits.
Okay.
And a good one for Finland, for Satu. Two behind.
And Penny takes that one.
Yeah, she needed that. So she is one hit behind Perilli, but Barsak has a chance to two
right
ahead.
And loss.
Doesn't take it. Which is good news for Penny Smith, because it'll be very difficult to catch Perilli, because
yeah,
Perilli's big number. But Barsak's a possibility.
A loss for Wang. Double bomb. And a bomb for Finland.
But Satu will be alright.
Yeah.
Yeah. Was that a hit for Penny Smith? Yes, it was.
Yes.
Leads to pressure on Barsak and a miss. So Barsak and Penny Smith now currently tied. And if it stayed this way, Penny Smith would remain in the competition based on a better bid number.
And the last targets, I think. Ah, oh, not yet. Second last. Still
yep
going. Good job.
So this is an important one for Penny Smith. If she hits it, she'll be in a good position. 16.
At least has a chance.
Yeah, so the pressure's on to Barsak now.
And
a
lost.
Second miss. So.
Now it's going to be
that does mean that
all in the last round.
Well, with this being the last round, I think it means
yeah
Penny Smith definitely wins, because even if she missed and Barsak hit.
But we don't know about the...
Oh, the deduction, yeah, which I forgot about again. I'm so glad you're here, Mopsy, for your eyes and your memory. You've got a good memory.
And they say,
oh,
I'm Dory.
Bad one.
I think you're Dory.
Dory? What's that?
From Finding Nemo.
Oh, never seen it, but fine. I'm an animated fish, apparently. Thanks.
Who has the brains for 2 seconds.
Ah, okay, I get
they
it.
It's me.
Got
it was a goldfish or something like that.
Okay, cool. Then at least.
But few more. That was the last. Okay.
It was. So Tatiana Barsak of the Russian Federation finishing with 16 hits. So she leaves the competition in sixth place. Now that does presumably
yes
mean that
yeah
Penny Smith's target was or point deduction was taken off, unless we were misinformed.
But it says there 17 and Barsuk 16. It might be still the 1 point, and then the bib number.
Ah,
is
true.
The, yeah.
We don't know, but hopefully you're seeing on your screens at home the correct score. Because as mentioned previously, in case you're just joining us, we do, due to some technical difficulties, have lack anyway of information in front of us. We're relying on a scoreboard that's a long, long way away, and as
so Fatima in the lead, and then Mäkelä Nummela in the second position, and then third Perilli and Van, and then Smith in the fifth.
Okay, so yeah, so Penny Smith's got to do it all over again.
Yep.
To survive. And her closest rival is your friend at the moment.
Yeah. Good hit.
Yeah, very good. Everyone's going well.
Yep.
It's up to Penny Smith now to continue that trend.
And after 5, we'll see what happens.
Absolutely. So the eliminations keep on coming after each five targets. So another four each for fifth place will be decided. Everyone's going well, aren't they?
Yeah.
Have a hit for Penny Smith as well, and we're back with Perilli. Oh. And over to Wang. There's a miss.
Okay, the first hit. Sorry, lost.
It's all right, I forgive you. Galvez restoring her lead.
And a loss for Finland.
Gives Penny Smith a chance to close the gap.
Yeah.
She does, so one target between Finland and Australia.
There is also Wang. Wang and Smith has the fourth.
Wang and they're both on 20 hits each, yeah.
They're really close to each other, everybody.
They are, it's very tight.
Fatima in a small lead.
Yeah, she's the one to catch. Another hit. So back over to Michaela Nomela. Hey. No problem.
Yeah, nice. That was also. They got beautiful hits, you know.
Yeah.
Yeah,
especially with the conditions as well. You feel it? I feel the rain's heavier now, do you?
Yeah, it's a little bit come more now.
But as you said, there's not much wind.
Yeah.
Which is good news for the shooters.
But they will be really wet after this.
Yeah, they will.
And Fatima? With Fatima?
A rare miss for Fatima.
Yeah.
She's on to 25. Satu of Finland moves on to 23, so two behind the leader.
Yeah.
Oh, and a miss for Penny Smith, so that could be costly for her.
And that was the last one.
It was, therefore, costly for her. Penny Smith, youngest shooter in this final, 22 years of age, of Australia, taking fifth place in the trap women's final at this ISSF World Cup Changwon 2018. So congratulations to her. No shame whatsoever. Fifth place at a World Cup. But there are four athletes remaining now. Let's take a look at them via the wonderful eyesight of my lovely guest, Mopsi Feroma of Finland. What are you seeing?
Yeah, Galvez, Fatima in the lead, and then Finland coming strongly in the second place. And then Perilli third and fourth with Wang. Ah, yeah, Wang, sorry.
So Wang's in the danger zone now.
Yeah.
But just one behind. Well, now that's two behind Perilli, but she has got a shot in hand, which is coming up now.
Yeah. And lost.
Doesn't take it, so two hits behind Perilli.
But five targets is a long one sometimes. Anything can happen.
Yep. Good one for Satu, and it's back to Perilli.
Yeah. And lost again. No, it was,
it was a miss, wasn't it? Yeah, miss. That gives Wang a chance. Oh, no, Wang doesn't take it.
Nope. So she's a bit behind now.
She is running out of targets as well.
And now Fatima missed also.
Is that 26 for Gal?
26, yeah. And now Satu can make a 25, but loses, and 24 is the next to Fatima.
Yep, which is one more than Perilli.
Yeah, Perilli was one behind, and now they're getting the new round. I think that was a broken one. Yeah, she will get a new one.
Okay, so Wang goes again.
Yep.
Needs to get this. And she does. Back to Galvez. Can she bounce back from that recent miss? It's a rare miss.
Yeah, she got it. So back in a big lead. Well, three.
And a hit for Finland.
And loss for Perilli.
Here comes Wang.
But I think it will be Wang next who is out.
Does look that way.
Yeah.
If she was to catch Perilli, she has got the higher bib number.
Yeah. Yeah, I saw that.
What's going on there? What can you see, Mopsy?
They say it was a loss, but I even saw that there came a small piece.
So you saw that and we didn't see much because there are umbrellas and everywhere and people. So if you can see that from here, then...
Can I say something?
Put your hand up, Mopsy. Put your hand up. Shout. Well, they're investigating anyway to protest. Yeah. So let's see what the outcome is. Satu, Mikela, Namela.
These are sometimes really difficult. And also, I have noticed when you're a side referee after your own squad, sometimes you're so in it in what you were just doing that you just don't focus that much and you are like, oh, he didn't hit or she didn't hit, okay. Or then trying to see it.
And for the shooters, it must be a challenge, especially in these conditions, just to stay focused as
Yeah. Or did it come in the wrong place? There's now a bigger problem, I think. They are trying to get it back. But luckily, Satu has been in these finals many times and know how to just get the hand up, like saying, not gonna take it if it's a bad target or. And I think Satu is getting a new one. Maybe it was a broken one, but I thought I saw a piece when she had shot. But I think they're going to give her a new one.
Does look that way, yeah. It's like
now
resetting.
Now it's on the wrong place.
We'll get there.
Yeah. Now it's on Sato's place and she will shoot it again.
She's going to have to get her focus back on.
Yeah. These things happen. It doesn't make anything. No! What? Huh? Now I'm confused.
Yeah, what's going on?
I thought
that was Perilli.
No, I think Sato got a hit.
Satu was given a hit.
Ah, yeah.
So she won the protest. So what you saw was right. You saw a bit of the clay. So that was Perilli now.
Yeah. And now she has a problem.
She's protesting.
Yeah. Well, that I didn't see. Sorry.
That's all right. I can't see anything. So you saw a lot more than me. But we're getting there. We're getting there. But Perilli is certainly not happy.
Because the people at home can't see that we have this big, what is it?
It's like it's a pillar, yeah. Yeah. We've got a pillar in front of us. We've got humans and we've got their umbrellas. Yeah. We would normally have a screen showing us the camera shots, but as mentioned, due to some technical difficulties, we don't have that, so we're just relying on.
Yeah, and it was just in the Satu's place, so we didn't know which place she was, but luckily she got it.
Yeah.
But now they all are missing.
Yeah, I don't know if that's to do with the break in proceedings, but yeah, Perilli miss, Wang miss, Galvez miss.
And Satu takes it.
Satu does. And we go again.
Getting closer to Galvez. But now...
That's it. So, fourth place has been decided. In the People's Republic of China is Wang Jiao Jin. Coach on hand, or team member on hand anyway, to bring her into the dry, an umbrella over her head, finishing on 23 hits. That was one behind Perilli. So I think the confusion's over now.
Yeah.
And we have three athletes remaining.
Let the next one come.
Five targets away from the bronze medal. The leader goes without saying, for now anyway, it's been this way. Fatima Galvez leading. She's got 28, is it? Yeah.
Yes.
And then one behind.
Mäkelä Nummela.
Yeah, from Finland on 27. You say that name so well. I'm Satu Mäkelä Nummela. And then Perilli is still there with 25.
And Fatima loses one.
So that's a chance for Satu.
And she takes it. Now they are head to head.
So things are getting very interesting, aren't they, out there?
Yep.
From what we can see.
And they have three before Perilli, so, and Perilli loses one more. But still, three, four targets. And Fatima loses.
Two misses for Galvez. What do you call it? Double?
Double bum.
Double bum, I like that.
Or double loss, of course.
Satu's taking the lead.
Yep. We come slowly from the behind.
It happened before in Guadalajara.
Yes.
The mixed team.
Really strongly.
Third miss on the trot for Fatima Galvez of Spain.
It might also be the rain already kicking in a little bit.
Getting heavier.
Everything is slippery.
But also we had the two protests, the confusion.
Yeah.
Certainly confusing for us. And then everyone started missing, didn't they?
Yeah, true. Except Satu.
Yes.
And that was
a missed for Perilli. It's fair to say the bronze medal will be going to San Marino.
I think there's no, well, nearby, but if Fatima gets this and she got it, so I think Perilli will be third, but let's see.
Very well now is Satu of Finland, 31. A hit for Perilli.
Yeah.
Won't be enough though.
No.
Galvez needs to keep up the pace. Keep breathing down Satu's neck. Won the difference. Chance to increase it back to two. And it's taken. So, bronze medal. As predicted, Alessandra Perilli of San Marino, finishing with 27 hits, takes the bronze medal. That's her fourth bronze medal at a World Cup, adding to the two she won last year, Marnica and Acapulco. And that's her eighth World Cup medal in total. So congratulations to Perilli, challenging conditions out there. We've got two athletes left now, 10 targets as well for the gold medal. We can forget about bib numbers now, because if we ended up with a tiebreak situation after 10, we would have a very soggy shoot-off, wouldn't we, to settle that situation. But we have Galvez on 30 and Satu on 32. How are you feeling as, looking on, your teammate out there? How are you feeling, Mopsy?
Oh, I think my heart is going to jump any moment, so.
I think at this stage in Guadalajara, when you were commentating with me, we were doing the mixed team event, you sort of at this stage kind of stopped talking to me, didn't you? Because you were concentrating so much.
No, I'm thinking it will
I need you more
happen.
Than ever, though, because, we had our scoreboards and what have you with us in Guadalajara in front of us.
Yeah.
And we don't hear. I need your eyesight. And I need your communication. So please.
Yeah.
I know you're willing your teammate on out there, but please stay with me. Stay with me, Mopsy.
And guess what? It might be a second record for Satu now, if she wins.
Yes.
They got the world record with Vesa.
Yes.
From the mixed, and now if she wins. But anyway, which one ever gets it, I think it will be the world record. I'm not sure, but I'm guessing. It would be awesome to have 2-1.
It's not bad, is it?
Nah. 10 long targets.
It's still 2 the difference between the two remaining finalists out there.
And 7 to go, I think.
Yep, that's right.
Good.
I think.
Let's just agree.
Yeah. That's all we can do. This is Fatima Galvez.
And no loss. Miss. And so now if Sato takes it, it's one more to her.
Yeah.
Oi! Sorry.
Remains. That's all right. You show your emotions. It's fine. Maybe jump a bit, but... So two is the difference still, with six remaining.
Better not jump or we will be on our backs.
Yeah. I feel the wind's picking up a bit. It feels colder, doesn't it now?
Yeah, and the rain is coming more harder again.
So you gave it four or five in terms of how challenging it is. What would you say now, these conditions?
I would say now 6 to 7 because it's a long time you have been there. Your towel and everything starts to be so wet. So it just makes everything a bit harder.
Yeah, feeling heavy out there, I'm sure.
Yeah.
Two is still the difference with five targets remaining now. So Finland currently in the lead.
You have any duct tape?
Duct tape? No, I haven't.
Damn.
Yeah, sorry.
Because I think I'm going to burst in. happy.
Release your emotions. It's fine. I can't duct tape your mouth even if I had some. That would be kind of cruel, I suppose.
But Fatima lost one and now it's 35 against 38. So looking strong.
Looking very strong, yeah. Two very experienced shooters, 13 World Cup medals between them. Six for Satu, seven for Fatima, they're about to get another each.
And Fatima loses one more.
And therefore, it's looking like the sixth gold medal of the World Cup for Satu Michela Novella.
Yes, I think it's quite settled. There's only two left.
It's settled, yeah.
And it's 39 against 35.
It'll be Fatima Galvez's third silver, taking her total World Cup medals to 8. There are still targets to be fired at here. The rain continues to fall. Galvez gets that one.
So one more after this, and it's finished.
Are you ready to release that emotion?
Almost.
I think that's a yes. There is some kind of tape up there, over there, actually.
Oh, yeah. But now you can't use it anymore.
So Galvez, it's her final target. Over to Satu to seal the deal.
Finland wins! Satu wins! Woo!
And Mopsy said it. Gold medal going to Satu Michela Novella of Finland. Finishing on 41 hits. She lifts her gun into the air, accepts the applause and the shrieks here from Mopsy Broma, her teammate, my guest here in the commentary booth. And the silver medal goes to Spain, to Fatima Galvez, finishing with 37 hits. And a reminder that the bronze medal went to Alessandra Perilli of San Marino, who finished on 27. So these guys out there, very challenging conditions. And there was some good shooting, wasn't there, Mopsy?
Yeah, really good shooting. Love it.
In a slightly unbiased way, how would you describe this final for you? How was it?
I can't look at it. It's too stressful.
But a very good day for Finland anyway.
Yes, of course. So, next time Finland is there, I have to be here.
I think you're the lucky commentary charm, aren't you? Yeah, because we had it in Guadalajara and we've had it here now in Changwon. So that's our first shotgun medals of this World Cup decided. So once again, San Marino, Alessandra Perilli taking the bronze, Fatima Galvez of Spain taking the silver, and the gold going to Finland, to Satu Michela Novella. So that's pretty much it then for today. Day two of the ICCF World Cup Changwon 2018. A very wet, soggy Chang won. We will be back tomorrow for more in hopefully drier conditions, although the weather forecast isn't looking good. So, Mopsy, thank you for joining me
once again.
And have a safe journey home. And obviously, best of luck for the rest of the season. Where will you be competing at next?
Malta World Cup.
Malta? Okay.
Yeah. So I hope to see you there.
I hope to see you there too. And obviously, out there in the final, first and foremost. But if not, you're more than welcome to come and join me.
Thank you. Yeah. It's always a pleasure.
Imagine it's sunnier conditions.
Let's see.
Yeah. So thank you, Mopsy. And thank you at home for joining us. This final will be on the ISSF YouTube channel in the very, very near future. So feel free to check it out or share it. ISSF also on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, all the social medias. So get involved. See photos and interviews and all sorts of exciting nuggets of information from this World Cup and World Cup's gone by. But that's it for now from the rain in Changwon. We'll see you again tomorrow.